Now, in this part, we'll be discussing the ways of increasing the magnetic field around a solenoid, and then we'll see how we can develop an electromagnet. So this is a simple topic of ways of increasing the magnetic field in a solenoid. Again, we are drawing the solenoid and the circuit diagram quickly. This is the same diagram which we have drawn in the previous video. So, this is the same diagram. So, in this, ways of increasing the very first way of increasing the magnetic flux or magnetic field which is being set up around is by increasing the strength of current. By increasing the strength of current, when the current increases, the magnetic field forming, it will also increase. So this is the first method of increasing the strength of current. The next method is by increasing the number of turns in the coil. When we are increasing the number of turns in the coil, then the amount of current flowing will also increase, and that will directly increase the amount of the magnetic field or magnetic strength. Third and the most important, that will form the base of the electromagnet, this is by inserting a soft iron core inside a solenoid or coil. If we are inserting a coil, if we are inserting a core of the iron, soft iron core, if it is being inserted over here, then also the magnetic strength is increased. Now, let you just imagine why I am, when I am saying the strength, it means the concentrated field of the magnetic. When magnetic fields, they are more concentrated, means the magnetic field line, they are very compact and dense. So, let us just take two cases. This is the solenoid which is without the soft iron core. This solenoid is having the insertion of the soft iron core. This is the soft iron core. So let me just label it as soft iron core. This is without, this is with soft iron core. Now the magnetic fields which are being set up over here, it would be like this. And then it would be, you would say, like this. Then there are some scattered form like this. Why? Because in this, the magnetic field lines, they are passing through air. Air is not, you would say, allowing the magnetic field lines to pass through that. So this, for this, we are using a very important term known as permeability. Permeability is a very, very important term in magnetism. Permeability means it is the ability of a particular substance or a matter which allows the magnetic field lines to pass through them. If a substance is having less permeability, means it restricts or it does not or it obstructs the flow of the magnetic field lines through that. So, air is having low permeability. So, here it is passing through empty space, which is air. So, that is having low permeability. So, these are less dense. Means field lines, they are very far apart from each other. Now, when I am going to draw the magnetic fields here, these magnetic fields, they are highly concentrated. These magnetic fields, they are highly concentrated over this area, very less concentrated, densely present magnetic field, because soft iron core is having high permeability.
means it easily allows the magnetic field to pass through them. Thus, soft iron core is having high permeability because it allows the magnetic field line to pass through them. Even if magnetic field lines tries to move away, the soft iron core will attract, or you would say it will allow that magnetic field line also to pass through that, because it is having very, very high permeability. But air, it is having very low permeability, so it will not allow the magnetic field line to pass through them. So from these two diagrams, it is clear that this is having less concentrated magnetic field, or in other term, less magnetic field. This is having dense magnetic field or more magnetic field. So these are the three ways of increasing the strength of the magnetic field. First, by increasing the current with by increasing the amount of current, which directly increases the magnetic field, by increasing number of turns, which first increases. When number of turns increases, more amount of current is now flowing, that will also increase the magnetic field. And by inserting the iron core, the permeability increases. Thus, more and more field lines will be passing through this soft iron core, and thus it will also increase the strength of the magnetic field. So these are the three methods through which we can increase the strength of the magnetic field around a solenoid. So now we'll discuss the how we can make the electromagnet. Now we'll be starting with the electromagnet. So let us start by defining the electromagnet. Electromagnet is a temporary, yet strong magnet. It is temporary strong magnet which is formed, when electric current is made to pass through a coil. Wounded around a soft iron core. So this definition is having many points or many things which we need to understand or remember. Electromagnet is always a temporary magnet which is formed only when the current is passing through a coil which is wounded around a soft iron core. When the wire is wounded around the soft iron core, this soft iron core is getting converted into a temporary magnet. Why the name is electromagnet? Because this thing will persist its magnetism as long as the electric current is passing through this. When the electric current is made to withdraw, this magnetism will be lost. Now let us just start with the circuit diagram straight away. So let me make the circuit diagram somewhat here, because we'll have to write something on the upper section of the board. So this is the diagram. Along with this, we are having a rheostat, then we are having an ammeter, then we are having this plug. And we have inserted a soft iron core inside this solenoid. So this is the solenoid, this is the soft iron core. Let me just name it as soft iron core. Rest circuit is same. Now I am switching on the current by plugging in the key. So now the circuit is complete. The current will flow in this direction. So current is flowing again. This is the case when current is flowing in this direction. This pole here will be the south pole. So this pole will be the south pole, and this pole will be the north pole. As we have discussed, the magnetic field lines, it will pass through like this. Again, it will pass through like this. Now, in the previous section, we have discussed that soft iron core, it is having high permeability. So it allows the magnetic field line to pass through them. If it allows magnetic field to pass through them, then it means it also possesses some magnetism, because this is the property which is also shown by the bar magnet, as the magnetic field lines, it also passes through the bar magnet. If this is a bar magnet, this is north pole, this is south, then outside it is from north to south and inside it is south to north. Outside it is north to south and inside it is south to north. Which means this magnet, it also allows these lines to pass through them. Soft iron core, it also allows the field lines to pass through them. Which means it also behaves like a magnetism. Now, if this side of the solenoid is south, the same polarity will be acquired by the soft iron core and this side will form the north pole. Alright, this is how this has become a magnet. Now, if the current is withdrawn, where no current is now passing, this field will not be there. If this field is not there, then this field will not pass through the soft iron core and these poles will soon vanish. So, this soft iron core will just become a piece of iron and it is no more magnet. Now, how we can visualize it or we can observe it when the current is switched on? Let us just take some iron fillings close to this soft iron core. It remains attracted, which means this soft iron core has become a magnet. After withdrawing the current, we'll see this will fall under the effect of gravity. So it means the electromagnet, this magnet, it will not retain its magnetism when the current is switched off. Now here comes a very important point, which is known as the retentivity. A very important thing, this is retentivity. This is the important thing after permeability. Now retentivity is the ability of the material to sustain or retain its magnetism when the current is switched off. This soft iron core is having low retentivity. Means it will not retain any magnetism when the current is withdrawn. Thus, it will no longer remain magnet when the current is switched off and will become a simple iron bar. Now, this is how the electromagnet is created as long as the current is flowing. Now, there are some ways of increasing the strength of magnetic field or strength of this magnet. Ways of increasing the strength of electromagnet, what are those? Same, first is by increasing the amount of current. Let me write it like this. By increasing the amount of current, when current is going to increase, the more magnetic field lines would be there, it will become more stronger magnet. Then is by increasing the number of turns. If we are increasing number of turns, more current is passing and thus more field lines would be generated and the strength of this magnet will be increased. But the thing is, when the current is withdrawn, then this magnet will no longer persist as magnetism. It will become a simple iron bar. Alright, this was the electromagnet in which we are using a soft iron core which is in I-shaped. This is I-shaped electromagnet. This electromagnet here is I-shaped. Now, we'll discuss how the electromagnet would be formed if this is of U-shaped. Now, I-shaped, when I'm saying I-shaped, it means a single bar which is of I-shaped. So, this is simply the I-shaped. Now, we'll see how an electromagnet is created and how the poles will be seen if we are considering a U-shaped electromagnet.